where do we start? We've got an emerging market sell-off. We've got a trade war that continues. We had all those tech titans testifying on Capitol Hill, and yet stocks, small setback today, they continue to march higher. Does this make sense to you?
I think it does. I think the U.S. is still in pretty good shape. Earnings continue to be very strong, and obviously you have the tremendous boost from the stimulus. In terms of emerging markets, the word I keep hearing is, you know, contagion. Is there contagion or not? I think that we have to keep an eye on this. Obviously, with the EEM index, the emerging market index down 10%, and things like the Shanghai index down 20%, you're going to be worried about it. I don't think we are back to where we were in 1998. Not yet.
Well, you're talking about the Asian economic crisis. Thank you for saying that, though, because I've been wanting to ask somebody, how do you know when contagion starts? As you said, this looks pretty bad. And if I have been in the Turkish lira, if I'm in the rand, other currencies, it doesn't maybe feel like contagion, but it certainly feels like crisis.
Sure. Well, I think what you want to watch is whether the bifurcation continues, meaning that the weaker economies like Brazil, Argentina, Turkey continue to have problems. And does that spread to what I would call the stronger economies of China and Korea and some of the other, the stronger Asian markets? So we'll see.
What responsibility do you put on the Federal Reserve? Not necessarily saying they've done the wrong thing to hike interest rates, but if you go back several months, it seems that one of the things that started pressuring emerging markets, as it often does, is the Federal Reserve hiking rates, mm-hmm. saying they're going to stay on this path. At the same time, they're reducing their balance sheet and drying up some more liquidity in the global markets.
Well, I think what's interesting about that is, to your point, is it created a strong dollar. And I've been saying this all year long, that I think the strong dollar will continue. Obviously, the strong dollar for many emerging economies is a problem. And so to that point, I think you're right. I think what's very interesting, too, is you've got the central banks of the world who are very much coordinated and now are a little bit, lack of sync, meaning that the U.S. is becoming much more restrictive in terms of unwinding their balance sheets, raising rates. But in Europe, you've got Europe on hold, and you've still got German bunds at 33 basis points. So the gap in differential and interest rates, again, contributes to the stronger dollar. And then you got a Fed tightening, and the stronger dollar obviously is not helping the situation in terms of the emerging markets.